People from Texas to Nebraska are grateful to be alive today after more than 50 tornadoes swept through four states on Wednesday.
The storms covered 500 miles, bringing hail and floods. They also destroyed dozens of homes. Dale Hurd has the story.
Here we go.
Sirens sounded as a powerful storm system spawned dozens of tornadoes across four states.
We have a roof that just flew through the air here. This is a serious situation.
It's like what you see on TV. Never thought I would see it in real life.
The twisters struck Oklahoma, Kansas, Texas, and Nebraska, destroying dozens of homes and farms, anything in their paths.
We have a large multiple vortex tornado on the ground here south of Lincoln.
For the kids, they were scared. I can totally understand why they were scared. You're hearing sirens and hearing the wind. I mean, they don't know what's going on.
The Oklahoma City area seems to be the hardest hit, with at least 12 people from a trailer park taken to local hospitals and at least 35 homes destroyed. The Bridge Creek Fire Department near Oklahoma City flattened.
I'm telling you, please stay at work. Do not get on the highway.
Local news warned rush hour drivers to avoid getting caught in this situation. Flying debris and down power lines. Then came hail and record rainfall. Authorities today are assessing the damage and looking for more victims. Dale Hurd, CBN News.
Oh, what a horrible situation, and our hearts go out to those who have been affected by this. This is really terrible. We need to mobilize for relief, but right now it's just the trauma of going through this, and so we need to be in prayer for them. In other news, Benjamin Netanyahu has formed a new government in Israel. John Jessup has that story from our CBN News Bureau in Washington. John?
Thanks, Gordon. That new government could face severe tests in the months ahead. Prime Minister Netanyahu finished negotiations to form his new coalition not long before the midnight deadline, but it is a razor-thin majority, with the new government controlling 61 of the 120 seats in parliament. That slim lead makes it extremely vulnerable, and one or two defections could bring it down. The new government will be sworn in next week on Wednesday. Well, with today's vote in London and Britain, rather, projected to be the closest in decades, candidates have been doing everything they can to sway voters in their favor, including reaching out to the Christian community. Prime Minister David Cameron recently spoke to 45,000 believers at the Festival of Life all-night prayer gathering in London.
Let us be proud that this is a Christian country where we stand.
And Labor leader Ed Miliband promised to protect Christian freedoms internationally if he's elected as the new prime minister. Millions of Americans are gathering to pray for our nation on the annual National Day of Prayer. This year's theme is Lord, Hear Our Cry, which comes from 1 Kings chapter 8, verse 28. It says, hear the cry and the prayer that your servant is praying in your presence this day. More than 43,000 gatherings are planned across the country.
I think when you come out together, it makes a statement in your community that we're not depending on the government to solve our problems. We're not depending on business. We're depending upon God. And there's always hope as long as God is on his throne.
200 other countries are joining America in prayer today. And Gordon, the great thing that we know well is that prayer still works.
Still works because God is still on the throne and he still answers the prayers of his people. Keep that in mind. If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves in prayer, it's up to us. So we have to do it, and we have to pray for America and for the world.